Знаменную группу сопровождающих войск.
The Kremlin can always put on a spectacular military parade, but this year it excelled itself. More than 16,000 troops marching through Red Square in an impressive display. Among them, for the first time, soldiers of the Chinese army, as their president Xi Jinping, the Kremlin's most high-profile guest, watched on. In his speech, Vladimir Putin, the Russian president, paid tribute to the millions who lost their lives fighting the Nazis in the Second World War and called for vigilance.
In the 1930s, Europe did not see the deadly threat from Nazi ideology. And now, 70 years after, history is again appealing to our minds and our vigilance.
It may have been an oblique reference to Ukraine. The Kremlin often compares the Nazis with the authorities in Kiev. The annual Victory Day parade is a time for Russia to flex its military muscles, and this year was no exception. For the first time, its new high-tech T-14 tank was on display, said to be highly capable. Before now, it's only been glimpsed in public. And the Kremlin didn't pass up the chance to roll out its nuclear weapons either. At a time of strained relations with the West, these intercontinental ballistic missiles are a blunt reminder of the raw destructive power Moscow has at its fingertips. The decision by Vladimir Putin, the Russian president, to stage such a huge display of cutting-edge weapons this year is being seen as the West as sending a powerful message about the Kremlin's determination to project its power. Moscow is already under Western sanctions for its alleged support of pro-Russian rebels in eastern Ukraine. Most Western leaders invited to this Victory Day parade chose to stay away. For many Russians, that's an insult to the memory of their war dead. After the military parade, thousands marched through Moscow with photos of relatives killed in the war. Not a single family here was untouched, including the Putins, the president himself taking part in the march with a picture of his own veteran father who was injured in the war. Memories of Russia's sacrifice and the pride of its wartime victory are still a central part of modern life here. Matthew Chance, CNN Moscow.